Depth first search is a widely used algorithm when dealing with trees. We can, for example, use it to search for a node. But in the classic algorithm, we don't save nodes we pass from to reach that node, even though we may need them later. This is why in this video, I will show you how to save the path and how can we use it to solve some tree problems. First of all, what is a path? A path is the sequence of nodes that we pass from to go from a node A to a node B in the tree. It usually starts from the root. For example, the path to go from the root to the blue node is this one. Now, let's see how we can keep track of the path when traversing a tree. To do so, we will use an array where the first element is the root and the last element is the actual node. And to fill this array, when stepping on a new node, we add it to the path and before we backtrack to the previous one, we remove it. We remove it before backtracking because we're no longer passing from there, so it shouldn't remain in the path, we will take another way. An example is better to understand, let's traverse this tree. We start from the root, we put it in the path and we go to the left. New node, we put it in the path and we go from the left. New node, we put it in the path, now we have no more children, so we backtrack, but before we remove the actual node from the path. Now from the right, new node, we put it in the path. No children, we pop and we backtrack. And the process continues like that. In code, we take the DFS function, where we process the actual node, then we call again on both subtrees. But when keeping track of the path, we need another parameter path. We add the node at the beginning of the recursive case and we remove it before backtracking. Now starting from this technique, we can solve a lot of problems. The first one is to get the path from the root to a particular node we're searching for. To do so, we need a recursive function that returns if yes or no we found the node while filling the path. Here, we stop removing nodes from the path once we found the one we're searching for to avoid losing it. So if the actual node has the value we're searching for, or it's in one of its subtrees, we return true without popping. Else, we pop and we return false to continue searching. And in the getPath function, we create an array that represents the path, we call the function to fill it, and we return the path. We can also solve the kth ancestor problem for example. If we take this node A, here is its first ancestor, its second ancestor, its third ancestor, and so on. And we're searching for its kth ancestor, where k is a positive integer given as input. To solve this problem, very simple, we get the path to go from the root to the node we're searching for by using the function we made now, and if it has at least k plus 1 elements, to be sure that the kth ancestor exists, then we return path of len path minus k minus 1. Minus 1 because we need to skip the last element, which is the searched node itself. Before continuing, little exercise to see if you understood. We want to get the path from a node source, not necessarily the root this time, to a node destination. How can we proceed? Answer in comments if you have an idea, or you can just ask me to give you the solution. Let's continue. What other problems can we solve? We can, for example, solve the famous LCA problem, lowest common ancestor. We have two nodes, and we want to find their lowest common ancestor. The node that is an ancestor of both node 1 and node 2, and that is as far as possible from the root. For example, here the LCA of 14 and 18 is 5. If we have a look at the paths from root of both of them, we can notice that they pass from the same nodes, then they go from different directions. And the last common node is the lowest common ancestor. So we can just get the path from root to node 1, get the path from root to node 2, and search for the last common element. And speaking of famous problems, let me introduce you to the 50 Popular Coding Interview Problems course, a course that covers 50 problems that will benefit you if you're preparing for coding interviews or if you just want to become better in algorithms and data structures. An editor to try your solution, the ability to ask questions, complex analysis of each solution, and many other features to give you an enjoyable learning experience. The course link is in the description. A last example that I want to show you is the root to leaf path problem. A leaf is a node that has no children, and for each leaf, we want to get its path from the root. And because our modified DFS function keeps track of the path at each node, then what we can do is to add a parameter paths where we will store our paths, and every time we reach a leaf, we copy the path to our array of paths. And in our main getPaths function, we create an array paths, an array path, we call the function to fail paths, and we return it. We reached the end of this video. In BRIEF, to solve binary tree path related problems, you need to understand how to get and keep track of a path by using DFS, then adapt it to the problem you're solving. Like and subscribe to the channel, and see you in the next one.